What is up, my Squirtlex? It's Zai, your king, welcoming you back to more Let's Play Journey. In the last episode, we climbed the tower and met a friend. Yes, someone who looks exactly like us. And in this episode, we will be following them, or at least going along with them, to wherever this road takes us. Hopefully, to the top of the mountain. So, let's just keep going, walking alongside our partner. Now, in this snowy area, there is something different that you're going to have to be aware of. The cold works against your cloth. That is why that dolphin creature fell. Also, there are guardians out here, yes. It is incredibly deadly out here. But as long as you stay huddled close to your partner, it's not so bad. Because then they will keep your scarf power up. However, no matter what you do, your jump height won't be near as good as you would like it to be, unfortunately. So, let's just glide on down here. And the first test in this area is your patience. And I'm not talking about my partner here. No, it is this wind right here. Now, if you get behind these pillars, you won't be blown away. But, if you don't hurry up... Is he going to go for it? Nope, he's going to... Let's stay. Come on. Stay right here. Oh, no. Where are you going? Oh, they are persistent little buggers, aren't they? Anyways, if you stay behind, the wind will not blow you away. But the wind is very dangerous. It actually will tear apart at your scarf if you're not careful. So I'm going to help them a little bit by lighting up their scarf, which you can do by calling. That is another feature of the call. So let's stay behind this pillar. Right here. Oh, dude, you need to not be so eager. My goodness. Come on. Here, we'll help this guy out a little. And I will just take it one at a time just for him. So let's jump to this one because that is a bit faster than just walking. So just stay right behind it. Just like that. And as soon as the wind starts to die down, you can go for it. So let's hop. And I think we can make it all the way to this one right here. Perfect. No. Where are you going? Oh, I think he'll make it, actually. Lucky guy. Well, either way, it doesn't matter because I'll be able to skip that one and go straight into the crevasse, the canyon, I suppose, right from the get-go. So, let's see if we can keep up with him. He sure is eager, I gotta say. That's really the only word I can think of for him. Now, if you haven't caught on already, these right here in the snow, which we saw at the very beginning of the game, these are indeed gravestones, yes. As we get up this mountain, you will be seeing them much more frequently. But, right here, we can still see there's this little dolphin creature. He was stranded, and we help him out a little bit by calling to him, which gives him energy. But unfortunately, the cold here is just too much, and that is not going to be enough. No matter what you do, you cannot get him out of there. So we'll just keep going. Oh, those guardians are so unsettling. I do not like them at all. Not at all. So... let's try to go around that rock and continue along our merry way. So unsettling. But there is a moment of respite waiting up ahead just for us that we will be able to get to. You can just get past this wind, which is going to keep blowing at us. Oh, come on. Come on, guy. He sure doesn't like to make things easy on himself. I'll say that much. Up the steps we go. And I guess we can hop up the rest of the way, just like he is. And I don't know where he's going, but I'm actually going to go in here, just for a moment. Come on. We want to go inside, because if you light this up, huzzah, golden light. And what's more, these cloth creatures up here, they are going to take us for a ride. And up at the very top, if I don't get stuck, is a mural. Awesome. How pretty. But that is all that is here for us. And when we get that brief moment of warmth and happiness back out into the cold, we must go. Where is he? I think he got stuck up on the ledge up there. Hey! Where are you going? Come on. Let's go. Whew. And I guess they'll carry me a bit. Awesome, I'll take that. Let's go. And oh man, he is sure is dinking around. That's very playful, I have to say. Come on. There you go. Where is he going? Hey, there's nothing up there for you. There's nothing up there. Trust me. It's just that mural. I promise. Come on. Let's go. We have to keep going. Come on. Man, they are just having way too much fun. Oh, the light went out. Hello? Unfortunately, once the light goes out in this lamp, you cannot light it back up. It's completely frozen, those cloth creatures are gone, and there's nothing you can do. So we're just going to have to keep moving. And if he's not going to follow, I guess I'll just go on without him. Why not? So, while he persists, up here you're going to see that there is a ribbon bridge of sorts. And we are going to unfreeze this briefly by using our power. There he comes. All right. I knew he'd come along. All right. So let's try to unfreeze this. There we go. It's almost there. And if you fall, by the way, you will have to start this entire area all over again. Just letting you know. So be careful when going across this. All right. Let's let him go all the way across. Just like that. And this next area we're about to head into, I'm going to be very, very cautious because it is in fact the most dangerous area in this entire game. Things are about to get nasty, everybody. Oh, and the wind is blowing us right from the get-go, and hard too. So there are several different paths you can take across this giant snowy wasteland, and two of them are safe, one of them is not. The one that is not is going anywhere straight down the middle. Safe is to stick to the very, very edges, left or right. The left is a longer way, the right is a shorter way. That is typically the one I take, but we're going to be going straight down the middle. And for good reason, as I'm about to show. There are guardians roaming this area, and they roam pretty freely, so you have to be very cautious. First, right off the bat, I want to get inside this stone opening, and hopefully he is not too eager. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Hey, hey, you, get in there. Oh crap. Oh, no, no, no. And this is what happens when a guardian gets you. Hey! Oh, shit. You, come along. Follow me. Just follow me. I know what I'm doing. Let's go. We'll make it together. Let's try to follow this path again, but let's be very careful about it. Maybe if he goes inside this time, he'll, you know, maybe if he learns from his consequences and the wind doesn't resist me. Come on. You just gotta keep going. Just stay calm and we'll make it. So, see that pillar off in the distance? That is what we want to head straight towards. Come on. Hurry before the guardian gets you again. He will get you again. If you're not careful, I promise. There's one last thing for us to get before we are done here. Come on. Oh no. I don't like that sound. I do not like that sound at all. Hurry. Let's go. And as you can see, his scarf is significantly shorter now. And that is the price he pays for his ignorance. And as you can see, the wind is not letting up, nor is the cold. We look like as if we're almost frozen solid. However, we still do get warmth by pressing against each other, but it doesn't do as much as we'd like. However, in this cave, which is beautiful, to say the least. And again, a little bit of relief. Let's hop up here. And right here we have our last mural in the entire game. There it is. All of the murals that you have to find throughout this game have been found. So, for you platinum trophy hunters, although this game does not technically have a platinum, it still has 100%, so completionists, there you go. That is your guide. Now, the left side does take quite a bit longer to traverse around than the right side. If he does not stick really close to the wall, he is going to fall victim again, because the Guardian does get somewhat close to this wall with his vision. He does not get, if you're against it as close as I am, you will not get spotted, but if you're too far away from it, you very well can be. And there, again, no matter how far away you get, there's no escaping it. He will hunt you down and he will get you. Even if you hide under a structure, he will destroy the structure just to get to you. Come on, just keep going this way. Now, the end is actually still obscured by the snow, but it's not too far off. So let's just keep heading over this way. And there you can see the eyesight of the Guardian floating up above. I do not like these guys at all. All right, there it is. There are actually, believe it or not, two Guardians in this area. And I believe actually that's the second one that just came out. Okay, yeah, told you, he gets close. Very close, but not close enough. Thank goodness, where is he going? Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. No, 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 no. Oh, you idiot. You idiot. And that is the price. Again, he's gonna have to pay. Come on. Oh, I know. Come on. He seems so defeated. It sucks. It really does suck. Lots of progress wasted. Feels like, you know, all that hunting you did for those glyphs is for nothing, especially if you don't know where they are the first time. But, again, oh, I swear if you get caught again, though, I might just leave you. Alright, I can actually see the exit to this area from here. We could go straight through the middle, which would technically be quicker. He seems like he's drifting towards that too much. But again, I want to play it safe and stay as far away from those Guardians as possible. In fact, oh my god. And looks like our friend is going to lose the last of his scarf. That was some distance though, man. He went flying. Hey. Hey. This is why you follow me. Come on. You have no scarf now. Completely gone. I'm sorry. That's what happens. Okay, you have a little bit. You have that little sliver of a scarf. But mine is like 100 times that size. Okay, not really, but it's much, much bigger. Just follow me and you'll be alright. That's all that means. Sometimes you have to be the leader. Sometimes you have to be the follower. That's just how the game works sometimes. Some people tend to know their way better than you. And you're going to have to learn to accept that. I'm not being arrogant or anything. I just have played through this game about 50 times. So yes, I do tend to know my way. And you know what? I think we will be finding the rest of our way through in the next episode, everybody. Guys, we're almost done here, but I think we'll be finishing up here in the next episode. So, with that, guys, this has been the Squirtle King. I hope you enjoyed this episode of Let's Play Journey very much, and I will see you all in the next one.